So how are we supposed to find this guy if we don't even know?
I survived the war for this. Oh, all these cops. There's gotta be something to think, right?
Actually,
babe, can I borrow some of that mascara? I'm gonna get good and tight come Friday. His mother would be proud of him catching all those criminals.
Gus can't use it.
Grown men playing at being bullied.
Mess.
Gonna take some cleaning up, that's for sure.
I wish it hadn't gone that way.
Well, we shouldn't bring guns to work with them. We didn't have a lot of choice.
You have to admire the barefaced cheek of someone who tries to blow your brains out one minute and pleads innocence the next.
Yeah, especially when he's surrounded by evidence. But guys like Bigelow spend so much time convincing themselves that they're not doing anything wrong that they actually start to believe their own bullshit.
They get sloppy. Bigelow, Lightball, all of them. If they hadn't, who knows how long they could have kept this racket going.
Complacency or greed? It's always one of the two that brings them back.
No.
Any unit able to handle citizen reports of 211 in progress. 437 East 8th Street, Unit 8.
No.
You're under arrest.
You again? This harassment is starting to wear thin.
We found a box of pink slips in a warehouse full of hot cars. You signed for them, Lightball.
I signed for all the orders and deliveries. You'll need something better than that, cowboy.
Save it, Lightball. We already have all we need to send you down.
I've had enough of this. You either produce some shred of proof, or I call my attorney.
You're in the hole with the organization. We know about the debts, Lightball.
Mm-hmm.
I agree. I have a small problem. I'm prepared to help you in any way I can, Detective. I'll name names. I need you to keep this out of the paper.
You need to shut up now, Lightball. Gordon Lightball, I'm charging you with conspiracy and fraud. Hands behind your back.
Yeah, hands behind your back.
The LAPD Central Traffic Division has today smashed a nationwide auto theft ring, writes crime correspondent, blah, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, blah.
Here it is. Traffic squad detectives confronted a large group of armed thugs. After an exchange of gunfire, more than a dozen dead criminals were removed from the scene. The LAPD sustained no casualties. Damn fine work, Phelps. Now get out there and nail some more bad guys, will you? I want to finish reading this.
Yep, we'll go get in some more articles so you can sit around and read them while we do all the work. Yep. Show up just in time. Take some credit. Oh, another flashback.
My family runs a shipping business in San Francisco. We used to have two ships a week to Tokyo. We've been in shipping for two generations, Hank. I've never been on a voyage anywhere. I feel like Odysseus in the beginning of his journey.
The Odyssey took 10 years, Cole.
This is the American century. America can rule the world after we win this war.
We need to stay alive, Cole. These men are counting on us. Have you heard what the veterans are saying to each other?
No.
Golden Gate in 48. That's four more hard years of fighting.
Four more years.
The Fallen Isle. Cola King. Get you some King of Cola.
Oh, this is one with a woman's body. Oh, yeah. Oh, wait. Seems legit.
Phelps, Bukowski. You have a new case. Two women. Possible drink drive.
How is that a case?
Drink drive?
Maud says she was doped and that somebody tried to kill her.
Where did this take place?
That's the bit you're gonna love. Right across the street.
What?
A Chevy Styline took a nosedive off the escarpment, fetched up underneath a Cola King billboard. Up to it, boys. We got bad guys to catch.
Need a drink. I got the jitters again.
See you later, fellas. Try not to work too hard.
Look at you, Bantam. Brings a tear to my eye watching my caterpillar grow wings.
I'm just trying to fit in.
Educated, hardworking, straight as an arrow. Hey, break it to you, Cole, but you'll never fit in at Central.
That's a cop from the newspapers.
Son, you're a couple of shingles short of a Cole.
Stop just ahead. Her face looks familiar.
Well, that's June Ballard. Tarzan's sister, Beast of the Amazon. She's married to Guy.
Beast of the Amazon.
The captain has moved to Vegas now, but the two of them still have juice.
Phelps, traffic.
Detective Phelps. Hey, Bukowski. Long time no see.
You could have called this in by megaphone, Enrique. Phelps, this is Enrique Gonzalez. Enrique was a pretty decent middleweight.
What do we have, Gonzalez?
Broad drives right through the empty lot and off the side of the escarpment. Her story is that a movie producer doped her and her friend and sent the car over the cliff.
Was anyone hurt?
Driver's beat up. Not too bad, considering. If she hadn't hit that billboard, we'd be scraping both of them off the pavement. Passenger's a Jessica Hamilton. She's just a kid. Pretty knocked around.
Kid gonna be all right?
I think so. They've taken her to central receiving. If you want to take a look around, stall the ambulance.
Thanks. Do that.
One more thing. Watch out for the driver. She cuts rough.
Hey! Out of the way, bub!
If you're looking for the coroner, he's down by the crash site.
Mrs. McAfee, we would like to ask you a few questions, if that's okay.
I prefer to use my maiden name, June Ballard. You might be familiar with some of my work.
Not really.
Can you tell us what happened here?
You're kind of cute for a cop. Maybe a bit on the serious side.
What about me, June? I'm a big fan of
you?
Beast of...
I don't like. Keep out of this.
Oh.
We understand that you're still suffering from the effects of the accident, Mrs. McAfee. The officer says that you claimed that you were drugged. Who did this to you?
That rat slipped us a Mickey Finn. It's no wonder I feel so dopey. I can't remember.
Who drugged you, Mrs. McAfee?
You really are a cute detective, but a little too naive for my taste.
I got that one wrong. How do we get down there?
This is a big scene, Phelps. We need to get our bearings. Let's go see the coroner.
How do I get down there?
How bad is it? Come on, you can tell me.
You'll want to see this, Phelps. There, laid out on the trunk. And that isn't even the best part.
They've been torn off. Where did you find them?
They were stuffed in the young lady's handbag. I'll run a trace for semen when I get back to the lab.
She's a long way from home. Looks like they're lucky they weren't more badly injured.
You ain't kidding.
Must have been unconscious. Being relaxed tends to lessen the soft tissue damage.
Drunk driver?
Maybe not.
How so?
Well, a head I found without a body piqued my interest. See what you think.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio. Is it real?
No. I think it's supposed to be a replica of an Indian shrunken head. It's some kind of curio or movie prop. See the casting marks?
What's it made from?
Plaster of Paris would be my first guess, then painted.
So we can rule out the murder angle?
No, you can rule that in. That thing was wedging the accelerator to the floor. Whoever did it wanted these women dead.
We should speak to Ballard again. She might not be telling us the whole story.
Another day, another dollar.
Yeah, she ain't telling us the whole story. She ain't telling us the whole truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. So help her God.
What can you tell us about the passenger in your car?
Jessica Hamilton. Poor Jessica. It's been a rough day for her.
Yeah, whatever, Harry Potter.
She's desperate to break into movies. What more can I say?
How old is Jessica, Mrs. Ballard?
I couldn't say how old Jessica is. Old enough, sweetheart, as the saying goes.
We found a shrunken head. It was used to tamper with your car.
You see, I normally don't drive off cliffs. The last thing I remember is getting behind the wheel.
It's obviously some kind of movie prop. You must know where it came from.
In case you hadn't noticed, I am the talent. And the talent doesn't deal with
props or sets or any of that kind of stuff. Why don't you ask Mark Bishop which prop house he uses?
You mentioned a Mark Bishop. You think he might have had something to do with this?
He is a movie producer.
As for no,
his
really?
Involvement, you just leave it to me and my husband to worry about.
It's not going to play that way, Mrs. McAfee. We'll take it from there.
Relax, detective. You're not nearly as cute when you're mad.
Dang, I only got Mrs. one McAfee, out of four, right?
I think it would be in everyone's best interest if you accompanied Patrolman Gonzalez back to the receiving hospital.
I'm being taken in?
You could say that.
On what grounds?
On the grounds that you are under the influence of narcotics and that you are withholding information from the police.
My husband is going to want a word with you, Sonny Jim.
I think we're good here. Let's go see what we can shake out of the kid. Roger, en route.
Nobody saw that.
Hello, Detective Phelps, here to interview a Jessica Hamilton.
Jessica Hamilton? Oh, yes. She's in the room right behind you, Detective.
You can't hold me here. No! I don't
feeling
need
better since this morning, Jessica?
Doctor. I need my lawyer.
Hey, my head still
where
feels
is the telephone? Do you know who I
am? Hello, Jessica. My name is Cole Phelps. I'm a policeman. I'd like to talk to you about your accident, if that's okay.
Okay.
Can you tell me what you remember about the crash?
It's all kind of fuzzy. I remember waking up here. Nothing happened yesterday.
Tell the truth, Jessica. Why the big cover-up?
I'm not lying to you.
Hell no.
We found your underwear and your handbag, Jessica. You need to tell us what happened.
The doctor told me what happened. I didn't want that. I just wanted to be a star, to be in movies. I told Junie what happened, and she told me to toughen up. That was the price of stardom.
Did she now, cold-hearted bitch?
It's not Junie's fault. It's not my first time. I had a boyfriend back home, but my father found out about him.
Even if you consented, Jessica, you're still underage. We need to get in touch with your parents, Jessica, to tell them what has happened.
Oh, you don't need to worry them. They sent me along to stay with Aunt June. They trust her to take care of me.
You're lying, Jessica. How are we going to make this right if you lie to us?
Please, Detective, why would I lie to you?
Because you're a runaway, Jessica, and you don't have your parents' permission to be here. Now, do you want to tell me what really happened?
I went with Junie to this strange place. It's difficult to remember. Someone gave me a drink to calm my nerves, and then I felt faint. I think I must have passed out.
How did you meet Mr. Bishop?
Well, Junie is a big movie star.
Junie.
You probably know that. She's doing a new movie.
What's the story with Bishop and Mrs. McAfee? Why does he want the two of you dead?
That can't be true. Mr. Bishop seemed very happy today. I mean, yesterday.
And that's why he wedged a shrunken head against the accelerator pedal and punted the two of you over an escarpment?
I overheard Junie speaking to him on the phone a couple of times. Screaming, really. She can be very hard sometimes, Junie. But they seemed okay yesterday. Like they worked it out.
I know what happened to you, Jessica. Where exactly did it take place?
Please, it's scary. It's really difficult to think of anything.
Someone tried to kill you, Jessica. Do you get it? Forget about being in movies. It's time to act like a grown-up.
I had to wear a robe and lay down on a stone. There were lights, a camera. It's not my fault. I'm not a bad girl. Why are you trying to hurt me?
Thank you, Jessica.
3 out of 4 is not
bad.
Been
a big help. Here's my card. If you think of anything or you need some help, just get in touch, okay?
Okay.
I think it might be a good idea if you went back home till you felt better, Jessica.
I couldn't do that, officer. What if I got the part and I wasn't there?
Delusional.
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go willingly to slaughter. Who the hell is that?
Must be her lawyer. He certainly expedited her release.
I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry? We should follow her.
Yeah, let's follow her.
There she goes. Come on.
Epic car chase.
Ballard is definitely up to something. Seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery.
Health is wealth.
Get in there and see what she's up to.